So I do that for about 6 to 8 weeks. I don't hear anything back. I mean, they're fighting cancer. And then in January of that next year, I get on Facebook again and long post, Parker's passed away. He's 15 years old. So just complete devastation. And I did, I felt myself overfeeling it. I kind of knew that, but I kind of felt like this is what I'm supposed to be doing. So I'm going to do it. So that had nothing to do with me, but I was like, so what do I do? So I was like, I'm just going to keep writing her letter. So then I stalk her husband's law office address because I don't know where she lives in Louisiana. I mean, we're just Facebook friends. It doesn't really mean anything. So I figure out this guy's address. I'm like, well, I'll just keep sending the letters. And I knew the whole time I was like, you're nuts. That's crazy. Who does that? But I just felt so compelled. Like I really couldn't control it. So I kept writing her. I probably wrote her for 4 months. And then all of a sudden, I go to my mailbox. It was on my birthday. And I go to my mailbox, and here is an 8-page letter from this woman. She has written me back. And she starts talking about her grief. And she told me after the fact that, you know, here she is living life with the husband and the 4 daughters, and they've just suffered this unbelievable, unthinkable loss. And she said if she walks into the room and everybody seems like they're doing okay, she said she couldn't just go in and be like, oh, my God, guys, I am losing it. Like this, I can't make it to the end of the day. So she would go and write me a letter and tell me about how she was feeling. And again, guys, we had not spoken to each other in 30 years. We really didn't know anything about each other, but we spent 2 years writing each other, just letters, no texts, no emails. And it was unbelievable. It kind of turned my head on a bunch of things because I didn't know if she was a Democrat or Republican. I didn't really know what she believed or didn't believe. All I knew is I cared about her. And then we started to trust each other through these letters. It was unbelievable. And I sat back about 8 months into that. And I was like, if so much goodness and kind of hope can come out of this one random Cajun person, you know, then what else is out there? And I did not intend to do anything good. I wasn't like, I'm going to go on a meaningful journey and woohoo, change the world and feelings.com. It wasn't that. I was like, I think there's something out there in this. So I put all my Facebook friends' names into a little box. I bought some stationery and it's like, Amy Wineland Daughter, your Facebook friend. And I start pulling these names out and I was like, oh crap, now I got to write these people a letter. And I didn't think I was going to finish. It was just kind of, I journaled it. I kind of took it seriously. That's my personality. But when I started, when I got to about 100 letters, I was like, this is going to be the greatest adventure of my entire life. My hand is going to fall. I'm going to hate it. And I'm going to look like an idiot. And I'm going to not want to ever go on again. But it was the most magical 18 months of my life and probably the best version of myself that I will ever live. To the point now, of course, I wrote a book about it just because it's a story worth sharing.